Hello and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2 Geheimnisnacht. We are back with the Ninzi Great Horde of the Goblins of Karaz. No, it's not Karaz, it's Azriel Ungol. And we were just about to defeat this small rebellion. My vessels are already added. And we are just going to make this province green, finally. Make it green. There are lots of new boys arriving at Khazad Belagar, all of them plundering and scrapping the runty hunts into proper green camps. Khazad Belagar is green! Okay, that's also part of our personal domain. Indeed it is. These mountains over here are ours to command. Really, I have 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How do I have 10? Oh, I still have this down here. But what else? This down here? This is also part of my domain, isn't it? Yes. 1, 2, 3. These are 4, and these are also 4. I have 8. Then I have 9 with this thing. What else do I have? How do I have 10 domain? Or am I missing something? I'm certainly missing something. What? I'm greatly confused. Can I not count? Oh, I have an odd tribe somewhere. That's the problem. This is already green? No, let's not make it green. This is already green. Give it a vessel. Okay, now I only have 9. That makes a lot more sense. Okay, could you go? Oh, you need to besiege this first. Yes, please go and crush these, what is this even? It's just an orc revolt. That's nothing compared to our goblin might. Okay, there it goes. Oh, we just won. And let's see. Who does this belong to? This belongs to the Kingdom of Karnach, which would be this guy, I think. Yes, let's give it to him. Clan of Indirium. There you go. Oh, you hate me a little bit less. Oh, you prefer Gorg versus Perverse Morg. He's cunningly brutal, and my god is brutally cunning. Yes. We don't make much money, but that's not a problem, really. We don't really need much money. We have 16,000 goblins under our control. I should probably build some greenskin camps around, like maybe in Karak Azul, because that's a really good province. Oh, that's just all of my money gone. Oh, okay. Wonderful. Let's see if I can maybe sell some prisoners. I can expel them. It's wait. What are you? Oh, you have you're a dwarf. You are a dwarf, but you are my lowborn. You are a courtier of mine. Okay, well then, I'm just gonna leave you there. Okay, so the Stomping Horde has a really large army. And I don't think I can actually prepare a war. I think that's only for orcs, which is kind of sad. Maybe it's only for orcs? No, it can't be only for orcs. We are the... It's not a cultural thing, is it? It's either religion or... your government type. How do I prepare a war? I would like to make a war against you. How can I do that? How can I prepare a war? Maybe I can't. But he could. He did, even. Against this guy over here. I can't I don't think it's a cultural thing. I think it is a warband thing. Let's see. It's not a warband thing. Maybe it's a religion thing. Priests, rulers, no. I don't see it, so maybe it is a cultural thing. That's sad. I would like to be able to call a war. Just because I'm a goblin, that's racist. I have the same right as orcs, okay? I'm just as green. Well, or maybe I can launch like a... No, that's not possible. It should be in here. Yeah, maybe I can't because I'm a goblin. That's pretty sad. Anyway, you only have 2,000 men, and I think your vessels are not that much stronger. 4,000 men, 2,000 men, and 600 men. Yeah, we can beat you. So let's go with the invasion of anything, really, because we're going to take all of your titles. Let's just go with the invasion of Geddes, because it's your capital. Of course, I could call some boys, but I don't want to do that. I don't want to spend my prestige on that. Three of my bosses would decline. Now, the problem I have is that it's probably going to be very expensive to call all of my troops to arms. And I don't really have much money left, because I'm an idiot and spend so much. 13,000 is still going to be enough. Actually, maybe we should just go with 10,000. Because otherwise I'm going to be poor. I know, maybe 7,000 will be enough. You know, we don't need that much money, that much troops, anyway. And otherwise I will be very poor. I still think we can beat them, even though I don't have my full force. Especially because I have so many vessels running around. Some of them actually did not... Oh god, I can take so many of them into my clan. Some of them did not join my war, which is quite insulting, really. Tolerance. Yeah, tolerance seems like something I really should have. Okay, so noble customs is not doing anything for me because they are not feudal. Temple is also not doing anything for me. I guess I'm going with Majesty then. And over here we should totally go with Light Infantry because that's like the bulk of our force. My liege. My mission in Karak Palik has so far been a success. During my visit to court of Big Boss God of It Horde, I seem to have managed to make him understand what a benevolent and peaceful ruler you are. Excuse me? And he sends his regards. I don't think that's exactly what I sent you to do, but, you know, it's okay. Okay, so we have some commanders. They all don't have any abilities except me. Like, I have some nice abilities. Like the mountain expert and rough terrain. Also a very good martial ruler anyway, but I don't really want to fight. I really fear to die. Okay, so they just crushed my allies down here. That's bad. What is this? He has a lot of heavy cavalry down here. Maybe we should not just attack them? Yes, wait for some reinforcements from our allies until they grouped up with us, and now we can go and attack him. We should crush his army first and then attack his holdings. That's going to be the best bet. What is this? This is a wasteland, so it's not even worth it if I fight that. We're definitely going to lose this battle. That's bad. We killed someone, but that's still not good. And he's probably going to follow us. No, he's not. Let's send home our troops. Because I need to raise all of them up again, but I need some more money. I need all of my troops to beat this guy. Because apparently we are a lot weaker than him is, for some reason. Not sure what exactly it is. We both have light infantry, so... I mean, we are goblins, so I kind of see the problem already. Should try to fight him somewhere defensively. And now that he's split up, that's actually good for us. We're definitely going to go into deficit here. Because we are paying a lot of money to our troops. And I can't really afford them. Sadly, he's no longer splitting up his forces. Oh yeah, he's attacking us. You can see we are immediately breaking from his troops. His light infantry seems a lot better than mine. That's not good for me. So So I'm not sure. We certainly need the numbers we have. Ah, now we are even suffering attrition, that's bad. Okay, we are no longer suffering attrition. Well, it's time for me to take up arms, I guess. Is he going to attack me? He might be. We are in a step, that's not good for me. Actually, no, a step is not rough terrain. Well, he's not attacking us, so... Can we actually beat him with our numbers at the moment? Okay, we are certainly taking attrition here. So let's get out of there. Yeah, he's taking some attrition as well, that's good. I don't like taking attrition, so let's go somewhere where we don't do that. Like right here. Is he attacking us now? He might be. And this is hills. This is good. This is rough terrain. Okay, no. He's... Where's his other force? He has split up his men again. Which is very nice. Which means we will attack him over here. Because we are... We have... Thrice the numbers of him. We should be able to beat him, hopefully. Let's see. Like, my infantry, why are you so bad? I have 10,000 of you, but you're really bad. We still won. But the losses were quite intense. We did lose a good chunk of our men. But at least we won. It's probably the heavy cavalry over here. Wherever he got that from. Black Orcs. Oh, Black Orcs are pretty tough as well. Ah, the Orc Boar Pit. Yes, that's it. We don't have that. Do we get anything similar? Get a Goblin. Oh, a Goblin Wolf Pen. Get some Light Cavalry and Light Archers. That's what we need. But I don't get that, do I? I have an Orc Boar Pit. Wait, I can get Orc Boar Pits? Because these are orcs and not goblins. Oh, I see. So it is certainly a cultured thing. Night goblins, I would get, but... Oh, light cavalry. Oh, so I can get light cavalry at least. That's good. We should certainly get more of those. 400 prestige. Yeah, let's upgrade these night goblin camps in our capital. We need that. And we're gonna crush his army again. Heavy cavalry is really destroying us because our light infantry is not made for that. We have a lot of commanders available to us. And we should totally get some. Like you, for example, are perfect for the flank, for the middle flank because you are a direct leader. You are an organizer, so you get on this flank. And then we have no one else. You are strong, that's scary. Well, I will go on the right flank, because we don't have anyone else who has any abilities. At least we crushed them this time. Yeah, I think his cavalry is dead. Wait. Wait, what? How did I capture my son? How did that happen? How did I capture my own son? We'll release him because I want him back, please. I'm not sure how that even happened. I'm gonna send him over here again. Okay, that was weird. We need to besiege some more stuff, really. Oh, someone usurped something. That happens a lot. I didn't set a timer for... Damn it. And my... I don't know where my mobile phone is. Wait, one moment. Sorry, didn't set my timer. I always forget that. Just need to do that real quick. I will set it for like 20 more minutes. Should be okay. There we go. Maybe 30. I don't mind doing a longer episode. Okay, so we nearly crushed them completely. Let's just take out this camp real quick so we get some money. And now, this is scary, this force right here. The heavy cavalry in it could really destroy us. But I need to take control of every holding he has. Okay, I think we destroyed his army here. We're gonna besiege some of these territories quicker. Can we attack them? That's a good question. There's a lot of heavy cavalry. I have some heavy cavalry as well. I will try, you know what? I will try. Because we need to beat them anyway. Oh no, we are suddenly dying. I mean, we are winning on the left flank. And the right flank looks good as well. But the middle is beating us. Yeah, the middle where the cavalry is, I think. Yep. It's just destroying us. Lost so many men there. This is tough. I'm not sure how to deal with these orcs right now. We lost a lot of war score as well. I will probably send my troops home and let them recover a little bit. I wish my my vessels would have joined me. Most of them. Some didn't. Three of them, which is a problem. I mean, we already took care of a lot of his lands, so we could just make peace and attack someone else. I'm not a leader of the siege, so I can't assault it. It's not gonna take very long to take it anyway. I just don't want him to free too many. Oh, magic! One of your chief has become a shaman, and is said to have been granted strange powers by Gorg and Morg. How did he do that? Dad him? He's gonna fight and smash our enemies for us. How did he do that? He's now a shaman. Can I request an item from you? I could. You are... who exactly? This guy down here. Okay, well, you are certainly someone important now. Can I... characters of special interest, yes please. Snicker Red Shield. He's now very important for me because he's a mage. Mages are important. Because they can make me magical items. And that's nice. Very nice. Okay, let's just quickly besiege some of his territories. As many as we can before we make peace. I'm not sure if we... oh, we can. Okay, let's just enforce our demands. And take what we've conquered. To the heroic Borbos Agro. Blessings upon you and your host. Accept your offer. Yes, of course you do. Send everyone home. Now we have all these new territories. Most of them are under my control. So let's see. But they should be all in this Drigus kingdom, I think. Except this one. Yes. This one can go to you. Do we actually have a... we have an uprising chance because it's a... because I'm an incompetent ruler? No, because it's a different culture group. So you, my friend, will get the clan of Udganach. There you go. And my son will probably get all of these other territories. Can I... I could probably create some, but I don't want to. So you're just going to get Penyon and Mokrane. You will get all these titles, basically. No need to worry. You will be very strong after this. But I don't mind that because I will be stronger. I will always be stronger than all of you little gits. Okay. There we go. There we go. Now I just need to wait until I get some money back. Because we are very poor. How can I rely on my generals when their understanding of warfare is so lacking compared to my own? I could teach Nickbit a thing or two. Yes, please teach him to fight in the mountains. Nickbit gratefully accepted my lessons on the art of war. With more generals like me, who can stand against us? Excellent. Yes, indeed, excellent. Okay, so you should be pretty strong now. Well, not directly, because many of these territories don't actually give you any troops, and they are also orc-ish. Let's see, our capital should have some decent light cavalry now. Ah, it's actually going to be upgraded as well. Still. So that's good. My orc boss smashed me? No. He's now my... Oh, you smashed this other guy, so now you are the war boss over here. I'm fine with that. Let's send our diplomat over there. We could attack the vampires. Yeah, I don't think they're that strong. We are fairly strong. What about this guy? This guy is so lonely down here. Let's declare war against him. Just call in our vessels. They will take care of this for us. This is a new kingdom, I think. No, it's still Kurganach, so that's fine. Yeah, just go and destroy him. You should have enough. More than enough to take out this orc. A black orc camp. That's pretty strong. Yes, we know that. Someone is lazy around my court, and I don't like that. So let's make him less lazy. The Night Goblin Cave has been built. Now we get 8,000 men just in our capital. I could build just another Night Goblin camp. Like, or the Troll Pen. 6 more beasts. Right now we have 24 beasts. That's pretty good. Because we have such an awesome multiplier thanks to my martial ability. That's my county capital. My capital. And we are goblins. So a lot of awesome stuff that upgrades our levies. Wow, we got a lot of money all of a sudden. So either I upgrade this again, or I upgrade Troll Pen. I think I will go with a Troll Pen. Just to get some more beasts. I think they are very strong as well. Probably the strongest units we have, considering how weak our, you know, goblins are. This war will be quickly... what? Oh. Okay, what are you doing? Numasian Reclamation of Saltar. Okay, so you have 12,000 men coming up here. And they are... What? What exactly are they? What? Oh, okay, pikemen. 5,000 pikemen. That's pretty tough, but you won the war, so... Oh! That's not good. We are now at war with Numar, because apparently... Yeah, that's bad. Huh. Well, sure. Let's raise our forces. We don't have that many men at the moment, because they are very... We've just had a tough war, and this one is probably going to be lost by us. He called in someone into his war. Nice shield. Nice banner. Do they all have that? No. Why do you have such a cool banner? Yeah, it's these guys. They have really cool banners. Anyway, this sword over here is probably going to fall. Then again, he still has a very strong cavalry force, so... Not sure. These guys on the other hand are very scary. I'm not sure if I can even beat them with... We have the same amount of numbers. That's not really good for us. He has a lot of pikemen. I'm not sure how good they are. But he also has a lot of special units and archers and light cavalry. We have some heavy cavalry, but I don't think they're that good against pikemen. The daily routine involves repeatedly swinging your blade at a training dummy. However, you can only learn so much from fighting an inanimate enemy, and the practice gets dreadfully dull after a while. I could use someone to train with. Yes, I could really use someone to train with. Okay, we are probably going to lose this war, because he's tough. Not sure if we can beat him in the battle. We will try. Hopefully... Maybe I could even get him to attack me. We will get this guy in the front again, and I will take the right flank, and we have an organizer somewhere. He will take the left flank. Let's see. I need him to attack me. He will attack me, so let's retreat to the mountains. We will not... we will make it, okay. Hopefully he attacks us in the mountains. That's going to be good for us. Can I build a fort over here? No. That's quite bad. We are losing troops over here. Supply limit is 11,000 and we have 16,000 at the moment. Okay, he's not attacking us. Well, we're gonna suffer some attrition right now. That's okay. It's acceptable. Until he has taken these two lands. Oh, he's probably going to retake his land now. I hope that he takes these two and then attacks us. Let's actually split our forces up even. And send some of them down there. This army needs me. And the... Actually, I want to have this, the left flank. And the direct leader should take the middle. And first of all, auto-balance these guys. Actually, yes, that's fine. And we need the organizer over here. So he can quickly get over here to help us out. Maybe I should just wait until he suffers enough attrition. But he's going to take out my vassals. Well, that's bad. Well, let's get down here. We have won the Siege of Charan. We've taken control of the holding from King Far of Numas. Okay. Not sure why you told me that. My great chairman Sikri tells me that his efforts to increase religious favor among the people have met with great success. A small army of zealots has risen up. That's good, I can reuse them. I mean, we are fighting against some heretics over here. Okay, we don't even have the number advantage anymore. Which is not a good sign for a goblin. He is going to attack us, so let's await him and see what happens. But if he attacks us, he's probably very confident that he can win. We should rebalance our troops here. No, maybe not. Get some more in the middle. Get some of these guys over there. Get these guys to the right. Okay, that's better. One of my commanders was just taken out. That's pretty bad. And yeah, we are certainly losing this war. Let's ask for white peace. No. Could surrender, but that's going to cost me money, and I hate money. Really, I was just a... I was only a tough soldier. Well, I'm now a skilled tactician, because combat is the best teacher. While with Agro of Nizhny, Great Horde has become more proficient as a commander. Which is good. Three more martial. One more intrigue, one more stewardship. Some health. And some combat skill. But we still lost this battle. And there was not even a faint chance that we would win this. So, we'll return all of our levies. These guys will also be disbanded. Because I don't need them anymore. And we will surrender. Because this war is over. There's no way that we beat these guys. Yet. So, that's pretty bad. Well, let's see, can we have... Do we have some prisoners? We have. Let's ransom all of them. To get some of that money back. It will take some time. My troll pen has been built, that's good. Yes, of course I will come to your little diner. Dinner, whatever. Wow, we now have 77 more beasts. Very good. And thanks to my martial ability, we even have more troops now. I lost quite a lot of prestige and money from this war. That's not good. I hate losing money and wars. And now I have a truce with someone. this guy, of course. Though I did not really attack him. I attacked this guy, and he just decided that it's time for me to die. I don't even know why he could reclaim this land. It's not even part of Nohakara, so... Let's get the party started, yes. Some humans over here. Some humans over there. Do we have more goblins nearby? I don't think so. The next goblins would be this guy, and he's too distant, I think. And also, he's a king. This guy, on the other hand, could be vassalized, but he's a distant realm. Could take out the vampire coast over here, which is not the vampire coast. The vampire coast is over here, normally. But I tend to call this the vampire coast because it's a coast and they are vampires. Yes. Okay, these are the last goblins. These guys over here. These are not goblins. The last three goblins, I mean. Actually, no, that's not true. I think there are some goblins over here as well. Boss Spinny has brought out the board game and pieces and suggested we play a few rounds to determine who's better at strategy. But that's not what stands, what it says here, but it's what I said. You played for hours, the tides of fortune ebbing and flowing as you tried to attack your opponent's positions without opening your defenses too much. Eventually, you found a critical opening and made a few inspired and aggressive moves and won the game. Hail to the war boss! I wish I was not a gardener right now, because this is one of the best traits you can get, the player, the game master, I think. Got some prestige for it, that's nice. But we really need money. There's no way we get money. Actually, we could raid, for example, this guy. So let's go raid them. Go on. And go raid. Can even besiege him now. Oh, we're taking attrition. Well, that's bad. But we're just gonna quickly raid them. And then get out of there. Take all the money we can get. Taking heavy attrition. Okay. Just take all the money. Still some to be had. And yeah, okay, let's get out of there. There's a weird bug with carousing at the moment that it doesn't really stop. He's just going to ask me forever now. Okay, you're my best friend. My heir is now my best friend, that's good. That means he hopefully doesn't bash my head in. What kind of goblin are you anyway? You are an average goblin. You know, fight a little bit and you might become a bigger goblin. We will go and plunder this because it has a temple and that's always nice to be plundered. Excuse me? Oh. The Runt Bands is challenging you to fight for the clan. Show him who's the boss. I'm gonna smash your head. As you draw closer, your enemy... Okay, let's see. He has a personal combat modifier of -1 and I have +2. I shall defeat him. I have 9 hit points left. Well, let's just attack the enemy. My steward died. You have slain your enemy. Wow, that was tough. What a fool. Just got bashed in the head. These guys are still looting, yes? Yeah. Oh, we are not even losing money at the moment. We just need to loot this real quick. I would loot some of these dwarven holes, but they take too long to siege down. Well, we can just siege this thing down as well, so that's not even a bad thing. Oh, this is Black Crag. Who knew? I found Black Crag. It's not even a special building yet. Which makes sense. I don't think it was taken in this year yet. But I'm not sure. As you place your training dummy with a real person, you find that facing an intelligent enemy is a lot harder, but also more rewarding. After many bruises and cuts, it's clear that you've gained experience and have better control of a fight than ever before. Good fighting, Grimlash Spinny Skid. I've got another personal combat skill. That's really important for goblins and orcs and greenskins, because Yeah, we were just challenged to a duel, and we could have died and lost the clan, which would have been really bad. I think that's just straight up game over. But I'm not sure, we might just lose our highest title and keep the other titles. We would just challenge him and then beat him up. Because that's how I do stuff around here. Oh, he's my looter now. And he's dead. Well, that's bad, because I wanted to he was my shaman, so yeah. That's quite bad. Okay, we have taken 14 gold out of this. I'm just gonna siege this quickly. And we got another 70 gold. And we are now in the plus again, which is good. Let's send our forces home. Now, unfortunately, I cannot come to your dinner because I don't like to have the carousing event up forever, even though it gives me prestige and would be good for me. Okay, we are making money. We have 9,000 troops out of 23. Could be better, could be worse. This guy still has a lot of troops, and we are weaker than orcs. We should not forget that. We are weaker than a lot of people, actually. But I could let my vessels fight another war for me. For example, I think I'm just gonna send them over against these guys. The invasion of Lazar. Just beat up the vampires over here. Go and get them. And they're not even vampires, that's the thing about them. They're just vampire followers. My heir, you have 2,000 men still, that's not enough. And you're not making it green because why would you? It's not really necessary. How's my tribe going? Like, they have high green skin control. That's good. What about Absolute? I can have a lot more vessels thanks to this as well. My vessels can no longer wage war. Okay, so they can't fight each other at the moment. That's good. But they can wage wars outside. I don't know why I would stop that. But I don't really have the control of it either way, so. You've changed your primary title to this one, Atira. I can create a couple of kingdoms, which I want to do at some point, but right now I don't have an empire title. But that's not too hard, wasn't it? Like, unite the clans. Yeah, I just need money, really. I can create the titles, the kingdom titles, and then I can do the empire title. So I just need to save up some money. Okay, could you not lose, please? Oh, you lost. No, you didn't. No, I think you lost. No, you didn't. Okay, very good. Thank you for not losing. Now you just need to siege this stuff down. They don't really have the strongest garrisons either. But I think my vessels are enough to take them down. I wonder, can greenskins have factions? Because I haven't seen one yet. I could also get a lot of money and make a wyvern. Sadly, there isn't really any land that I can plunder. Maybe I should go over. Like, I can only raid infidel neighbors, but actually, I can raid anyone. Any neighbors, because I just raided the orcs. But they're all really poor or super fortified, like the dwarves. And they're not that much worth plundering. It's guild hall, but that's not good enough. If you had like a temple or something, that's good. That's the stuff I need. You have a temple. Maybe guild halls are actually better. Oh no, this is a stronghold. I mean, I could just send everyone over here and plunder this, just for fun. I mean, it's not like they have anything else to do. But then again, I would lose some money. Just send them over there. We should still make a little bit of money. Oh. The defenders of Dominarch executed captives on the wall, angering the besiegers and strengthening their resolve. Oh. That's not a smart move of you. But they're quickly going to take this out. We have gunners? Where did you get gunners from? Where did you get gunners from? Do I have like a special building that gives us orc gunners? Or goblin gunners? That's pretty impressive. But yeah, they're going to take these territories out quickly and without much problems. We're just going to raid this. It's going to take forever. But it's alright. At least we don't lose any men in the process. Or not too many. Okay. We got some warriors. I don't need them, so send them home. Send them away. There's another goblin right there. This war is going to be over quickly. I could have probably plundered these guys. They are rather... rather rich, really. My intense study of warfare has led to an increased understanding of my tactics and strategy. Oh, what do you know? I'm now a brilliant strategist. Gives me another 3 marshal. Gives me 1 intrigue, 1 stewardship. And that's it. But that's pretty good. That will give me even more troops in my capital. Now we can have over 9,000 here. How many warbies? A little bit fewer than before. I need my prestige, so let's not spend it again. I feel like I'm not making as much money as I would like. But that's just because we have to besiege this thing forever. Who has the gunners? And how? Maybe... I don't think we have a gunner mercenary, do we? Gunners. No. Actually... Oh, we do! Yogurt's Ogre Band. And what do you know? They are... Yeah, okay. They are under contract of my goblin over here. It's pretty nice of him to even hire mercenaries for my war. But that's where the gunners came from. Okay, I see. Some cannons would be nice to take out fortifications easier. But that's not really Crusader Kings 2 then. Oh my god, it's already half an hour gone since I said we're gonna play for another 20 minutes. Anyway, I thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, then consider leaving a like and a comment down below. And we will see us in the next episode. Until then, take care. Bye!